By the way, folks, the reason why I'm taking it nice and slow is because I don't know exactly where the wagons were, and I didn't want to crash into them and derail them. So what we can now do is proceed forwards and then attach the rest of the train and enjoy this rather different switching scenario. So we can then proceed forwards as usual. I'm using the ditch lights just to make the train a bit easier to see, but this is the first time I've done a night switching or a late evening switching scenario. So without further ado, let's get some power applied to the EMD SD60 and proceed forwards then. What we will have to do, we'll just have to repeat the same process and attach to another set of wagons that will be on the siding number one, which I will do. And I'm just going to check that signal up ahead as well, so we don't get any signal past the danger errors as well. So we'll just have to keep that in mind, and we will have to throw the switch before reversing onto the final set of wagons, and that should be us just about all done. Okay then, according to the map, the switches are set correctly, and without further ado, we'll just use notch 2 to reverse our freight train onto the rest of the consist, and that should be us very much all done. But because it's night time and stuff, I will not go any faster than 5 miles an hour, as I don't want to crash. Also, another thing as well, folks, we are going downhill as well slightly, so we'll have to be ready to hit the brakes. I'm going to use the 2D map just to check the progress. But as you can see, so far so good, and hopefully it will end as a successful mission as well. There is no time limit on here, so this is career mode, but I have the scoring turned off as per usual. But in all honesty, folks, I do like these EMD and GE locomotives, so using a wee bit of braking there just to bring our speed nicely under control. Just going to check that map again. We are getting closer, folks, but it's just a bit of distance to cover, but I don't want to go too fast in case it suddenly crashes into the wagons, but I'm going to keep it just under 4 miles an hour, as that shouldn't be too much for the maneuverability, as you know, it does drop down to about 2 to 3 miles an hour, but as you can see there, we do have a slight hill we're going down, so I have to be careful of the speed as well, but we're getting closer to finishing off this very short scenario, and I do plan to cover the other two included scenarios with this add-on, as I got this in the June summer sales, although to be honest, we've not really had much of a summer this year of 2022 so far. And to be honest, 2022 summer has been one of the worst. But anyways, carrying on. Just wait until we attach to our train. And try not to go too fast. So, just put some more power on and quickly take it off, just to maintain our speed limit at 3 miles an hour, as we don't want to fail this mission, especially after going into all that effort of getting the first set of brake cars for this train. Okay, folks, we've just checked the mini-map again, and we are getting quite close now, so that should be very much all there is to do in terms of doing this short scenario, and I do plan to cover this locomotive again in another Let's Play, as I do like to use the ones that come with the add-on, and personally, I do like these locomotives. Okay, folks, I think that is very much all of us all done. Big thank you for watching. I know this one isn't very long, but it does get me, well, gives me the chance to get to use this locomotive and familiarize myself with the handling and stuff. But anyways, that's all for now. Big thank you for watching. Take care of yourselves and each other. And I will see yous in the next one.